both a dynamic and fragile ecosystem. An estuary is where a river meets the sea. Estuaries are special because they are transition zones from freshwater to saltwater and are regions of constant environmental change. Estuaries are not only unique in their environmental conditions, but also in the organisms that call this special place home. Only certain organisms can tolerate the high salinity or salt concentration in the water and fluctuating temperatures. The marine plants and animals living in estuaries are especially adapted to these often quick and drastic changes. This means that their bodies are able to adjust to the environmental changes they may experience. Mixed nutrients from both fresh and salt water, abundant sunlight, and shallow depths make estuaries very productive ecosystems. The animals that are adapted to estuarine conditions are more than happy to take advantage of this productivity. They are usually generous that are able to eat a variety of food depending on what is available. Because estuarine conditions limit the types of animals that can live there, these animals can take advantage of all these great nutrients. These organisms tend to use estuaries as nurseries, places where they can grow quickly and produce large populations. Estuaries come in all shapes and sizes and are known by many different names. Bays, lagoons, harbors, inlets, and sounds are all estuarine ecosystems. Though estuaries tend to share many of the same characteristics, the type of estuary depends on the geology that helped form it. Let's look at a few examples. Coastal plain estuaries are estuaries that are formed when glacial ice melts, which causes sea levels to rise and coastal plains to flood. The Chesapeake Bay and Long Island Sound are both coastal plain estuaries. Tectonic estuaries are formed when earthquakes cause the land to sink. Seawater then fills the sinkhole, creating an estuarine ecosystem. The San Francisco Bay is an example of a tectonic estuary. Fjords are estuarine valleys formed from glacial movement. Glaciers can cut very deep valleys along coastlines, and these valleys then fill with water. Some places you can find fjords are along the Scandinavian coast and in Alaska. Though estuaries can vary greatly, they do have some things in common. The salinity in an estuary will be the highest, saltiest, where the estuary connects with the ocean, which is also known as the mouth of the estuary. The headwaters where the river water feeds into the estuary will have the lowest salinity. The salinity of the fresh river water can be as low as 0.065 parts per thousand, while at the mouth it can be as high as 35 parts per thousand. That's a big difference. Temperature in estuaries also varies, and this is because they are very shallow. The water temperature changes depending on the temperature of the air. These changes can happen over the long period of a season or in as little time as one day. Productivity in estuaries is very high. Estuaries create a lot of nutrients and provide homes for some very important marine species. For example, oysters, shrimp, scallops, crabs, and a variety of fish depend on estuaries for food, shelter, and protection from predators. About 85% of the fish and shellfish sold in commercial markets spend at least part of their lives in estuaries. Estuaries are also very fragile ecosystems. Because they are so sensitive to environmental changes, they are easily damaged by pollution, landscape changes, boat traffic, and other disturbances. Estuaries support a rich diversity of marine life. And while they share similar characteristics, each is unique. It is important to protect these special ecosystems, not only because they provide us with food, but because they are an important transitional ecosystem connecting the land and the sea. Estuaries are areas where rivers empty into oceans. This creates a mixture of fresh and salt water, and estuaries have higher salinity or salt content than pure fresh water. The animals who live in estuaries tend to be generalists, meaning they can survive on whatever food is available. These areas also tend to be nurseries for certain species, providing an environment that allows animals to grow and reproduce quickly. bays, lagoons, harbors, inlets, and sounds are all examples of estuaries. Estuaries are also classified into specific categories, including coastal plain estuaries such as the Chesapeake Bay, tectonic estuaries such as the San Francisco Bay, and fjords such as those found in Alaska. The river that feeds the freshwater part of an estuary is referred to as the estuary's headwaters, and the area where the headwaters meet with the ocean is referred to as the estuary's mouth. Animals such as oysters, shrimp, scallops, crabs, and certain species of fish rely on estuaries as breeding and feeding grounds.